Until this past June, when our mom went to the hospital with troubled breathing. She slowly got worse and worse, always showing a little bit of decline. Sadly, the Lord called her home on June 21st at the age of 49. Even though she lived a short life, she also lived a full life. So then, there we were, at Seisma's, the funeral home. And one of the first questions asked was, instead of flowers, what organization would we donate to? We looked no further than MPS. Because of my mom's history of a selfless nature, it's also important to donate to places like MPS to help future parents get a little bit easier start to parenthood by giving families diapers, formula, clothing, and even counseling for those not sure if they can keep or want their baby. So, I urge you to donate to MPS because it will go to a great cause. But you don't just have to donate money. You can donate your time and resources as well. So please, help me keep my mom's passion and legacy alive, one unborn baby at a time. Thank you.
I'm the father of seven children. I think I'm losing my voice. But Mom would be very proud of you kids. This is really the next generation of people to advocate life in Muskegon. Young boys, their sister, that honor their mother. There's been so much said tonight. Nastara was amazing. Your story is absolutely amazing. And if we can be inspired by that to do something, to overcome the obstacles of our life and do something to impact mankind, it's just amazing. But that's the goal today. The goal for us is to say, as Star mentioned, what can I do? How can I make a difference? Everything's been said to really show us. Thank you, Pastor. I did that once to my pastor. It was that water that you're not supposed to drink. In fact, he's right over there. You know, he didn't have we asked him to come, and he wouldn't reserve his spot. You know, pastors do that. And then all of a sudden, he crashes the party. So he's at the front door, he says, is there a place for me to sit? And I said, well, no, there's not. You didn't register. So where is he? He's right over there. Pastor Wally Reams. You know, again, I had several things I wanted to say, but really there's been so much said. I think they pricked our hearts. They've challenged us to do something. But what I can say is that we have a passionate ministry. We've got people that are committed to the cause. If we can provide the funds, the volunteer help, they have a dream. And their dream is to touch the lives of those 300 that are aborting every year. We can make a difference, but the difference is going to come from finance. It's going to come from more help. It's going to come from more information. You've seen the billboards. You probably see the social media, but we need to do more of it. And if we don't, we won't stop the epidemic that faces our community. It's not just abortion, it's even the STD. So if you would, on your tables, we have a card. If you take that card and take a look at it, which you may be able to do, there's also envelopes. Once you've selected what you would like to give, you can put that into the envelope. I wanted to bring up a couple of the programs that we have. We started something last year, and it's called Business for Life. And this is geared for business people that may be able to do something to give back to their community. It's regular giving, monthly giving, or an annual contribution. There's several of those business people that sit in the room tonight that chose to be able to support the ministry. We also have the Guardian Circle, and this is for us as individuals, that we can make a monthly contribution to MPS. The other thing I guess we'd like to encourage you to do is do the best you can tonight. Give this team a jump start. Invest in their ministry. Invest in their dream. You won't regret it. And the other thing is year-end giving. It just amazes me as being a board member to see some of the checks that come in at the end of the year. People that have decided that they want to pick a ministry that can make a difference, and they send those checks in. So certainly you're able to do that. There's some information in your packet on your table about some of the upcoming events. We have a pretty exciting banquet scheduled for next year. Dr. Vida King, which is Martin Luther King's niece, has been invited and is accepted to speak at our banquet. That's amazing. Pastor Williams made a comment when he first came in. He says, wow, look at this place. It just packed out. What's going to happen next year? We might have to go to the L.C. Walker Arena. So what will happen after you fill out your cards, put in the envelopes, there's a larger envelope on the middle of the table. Please place all of your information in that. And then the board members will come around to the tables and pick those up. Thank you so much. This has been really an incredible banquet. It's been very inspiring, I know, for me. I am the father of seven. I am the grandfather of 29. Life matters. Life matters. And I guess as I heard the different speakers, I closed my eyes for a second, and I thought of my grandbabies, and I thought of my children. One out of four women will face abortion, but we can make a difference. Pastor Williams, could you come up and close us in prayer? And I'll take another drink.
It's been an outstanding night. Let's clap our hands for everyone that's been on the program. Especially let's thank Star one more time. Let's give a shout out to our new director, Deb Noel. All the board members, give a shout out to them, the staff, and all of you, the donors. One more, give God a praise on this one. Come on, let's give God a great big mosquito praise for the Pregnancy Center. As you prepare to exit, please be sure to shake hands and say hello to Star Parker. Also on the back table, we have a limited number of one of her books. It's entitled Blind Conceit, and I believe there's only about 40 copies. They're only $20. Please make sure that we support her and what she's doing by purchasing one of these. First come, first serve. As I prepare to pray, I want to bring out of my pocket this bottle. And every week in our church, we pass these bottles around. And it says, God's gift. As we prepare to leave today, I pray that you will consider what this represents. The lives of the children in the next year that will have a privilege of being a part of saving. I want to say it this way on behalf of those little kids. Get you goo. Now you say, what's the interpretation of get you goo? Well, as a grandparent, when you get your little grandchild's cheek and you say get you goo, you're saying you love that little child. Our get you goo is get going and let God use you to save babies, as Star said, one baby at a time. creation to call you Father. Jesus taught his disciples to say so. And here we are saying, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Lord, our prayer is that your kingdom would come in Muskegon, the kingdom of abundant life. Come through us. Come through the Muskegon Pregnancy Service. Come through the leadership of Deborah Noll and the board and the staff who serve so diligently, that individuals would take the best option. And come through us who desire to serve alongside of them. As we leave this place, Lord, help us to get going, to do what we can do, to be a part of what you are doing to save lives. We ask your blessings because you are the King, immortal, eternal, the only wise God. And so we pray to you, God, that you would bless this organization over the next year, and we thank you for what you did over the last year. We say these are the blessings of the Lord that we are grateful for. In Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said amen. Amen. Come on, one more hand clap of appreciation for the Muskegon Pregnancy.